Somebody sing me a gospel song. Tell me again that God's love is strong and not forgiven for what I've done wrong. Somebody sing me a gospel song. I need to hear the sweet melody with words about the hope he's given me, and that this world is not where I belong. Somebody sing me a gospel song.
I want to hear some good harmony, the words that take me back to Calvary, reminding me that by his blood I'm redeemed and I am loved.
Tell me about the race and tell me about victory,
'cause on days like these I know what I need.
Somebody sing me a gospel song. Tell me again that God's love is strong, and I'm forgiven for what I've got wrong. Somebody sing me a gospel song. I need to hear the sweet melody with words about the hope he's given me, and that this world is not where I belong. Somebody sing me a gospel song.
Savior who came and conquered sin. Oh, yeah.
Tell me about the miracle moment when he rose again. Somebody sing me.
Somebody sing me a gospel song. Tell me again that God's love is strong and I'm forgiven for what I've done wrong. Somebody sing me a gospel song.
And hear the sweet melody with words about the hope he's given me, and that this world is not where I belong. Somebody sing me a gospel song. I need to hear the sweet melody with words about the hope he's given me, and that this world is not where I belong. Somebody sing me a gospel song.
And that this world is not where I belong.
Oh no. Somebody sing me a gospel song. Somebody sing me a gospel song. Somebody sing me a gospel song.
Quite understand it. It's lasted for a long time. Don't know how to end it. Started out by praying. Got my friends to pray into. Yeah, God has never left me. Even on the worst days. After all this time, he's as close as in the first days. Grace and tender mercies. I know they're gonna see me through. Yeah.
I don't know the reason for the season of despair I'm living in, but I know the burden bearer, and he will carry me until the bad times end. I trusted him a long time, and he's always done the things that he said he would. And even when the times are bad, God's still good.
If you're in a bad way, looking for solutions, you won't ever find them in your own conclusions. But God can clear your vision, though nobody ever could. Oh, no, no. Come to him in faith, and then you'll know what I know. Nothing can defeat you, even when the storms blow, even in the bad times, you'll know that God's still good.
I don't know the reason for the season of despair I'm living in, but I know the burden bearer, and he will carry me until the bad times end.
I trusted him a long time, and he's always done the things that he said he would. And even when the times are bad, God's still good. I trusted him a long time, and he's always done the things that he said he would. And even when the times are bad, God's still good.
Redeemed, how I love to proclaim it. Redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed through his infinite mercy. His child and forever I am.
Redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed, redeemed, his child.
Blessed Redeemer, I think of him all the day long. I sing, for I cannot be silent. His love is the theme of my song.
I know there's a crown that is waiting in the underbright mansion for me.
And soon with the Spirit made perfect,
at home with the Lord.
Redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed, redeemed, his child and forever I am. Redeemed, redeemed, redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Redeemed, redeemed, his child.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Oh, let me hear from you. Oh, praise the Lord. Oh, it's so good to be with you this afternoon. We're here to lift up and glorify the name of the Lord. That's what we do everywhere we go. And I just have to be honest with you. I'm going to confess to you that I'm a Baptist. And I've just right there for just a minute, I got scared. I feel more Baptist-costal right now. No, it's so good to be in the house of the Lord. It's good to be somewhere where people love to lift up and glorify his name. It's good to look across the house and see people smiling. Sometimes we feel like we're singing in a holding cell for an execution chamber. And you know what? If you've got Jesus Christ living in your heart, you've got every reason to be excited this afternoon, because in him you've got everything you'll ever need. You've got the answer to every problem you'll face. If you wonder about the smile I've got upon my face,
I'm saved, I'm sure, I'm ready to go.
If you wonder why I love to sing Amazing Grace,
I'm saved, I'm sure, I'm ready to go.
Jesus died upon a cross and from the grave arose. I trusted him and now I know I'm saved
by the blood of the Lamb. Definitely, positively sure I am. Ready should my Savior call me, I'm sitting on gold.
You can take it to the bank, you can write it down. Nothing's gonna change it now.
I'm saved, I'm sure, ready.
Now, if you're saved, you're sure, and you're ready, let me hear from you right now. Come on. Even though the devil tries to take the truth from me,
I'm saved, I'm sure, I'm ready to go.
I can speak the name of Jesus and the devil flees.
I'm saved, I'm yes, sure, it does. I'm ready to go.
When the Lord decides to call me from this earthly domain,
I'm saved, I'm oh, sure, I'm ready to go.
Though he said to live is Christ, but to die
I'm
is gain.
I'm sure, yes, I'm ready it is. To go.
There's a mansion being built for me in paradise. My name is in the book of life. I'm saved by the blood of the Lamb. Definitely, positively, sure I am.
Ready should my Savior call me. I'm sitting on gold. You can take it to the bank. You can write it down. Nothing's gonna change it now. I'm saved. I'm sure. I'm ready.
Yes, I am. You can take it to the bank. You can write it down.
Nothing's gonna change it now. I'm set. I'm sure.
Oh, ain't nothing in the world gonna change it now.
I'm set. I'm sure. I'm ready.
Oh,
yes, I'm ready.
Thank God I'm ready. Yes, I am.
I cast my bread upon the water. My help being my brother. Struggling on life's stormy sea. I'll be sowing a good seed by doing a good deed. Now come back to me.
Well, I picked up the good book and took me a long look. I believed it each and every part. But I sure rejoiced in knowing about the reaping and the sowing. I really took that lesson to my heart.
I cast my bread upon the water. My help being my brother. Struggling on life's stormy sea. I'll be sowing a good seed by doing a good deed. That'll come back, come back.
Well, I can't buy my way to heaven, but there's a heaven awaiting. I purchased to buy our good and loving Lord.
And I'll go on a striving, trusting and surviving.
Well, I'm a holding on, expecting my reward.
On the water, helping my brother, struggling on life's stormy sea.
Oh yeah.
Well, I'll be
sowing a good seed by doing a good deed. That'll come back to me. Well, I cast my bread upon the water. About helping my brother, struggling. Sowing a good seed by doing a good deed. Now
come back
to me.
Yeah.
I cast my bread upon the water. By helping my brother, struggling on life's stormy sea.
Oh, yeah.
sowing a good seed by doing a good deed. Now come back to me.
Yes, it's gonna come back
to me.
Well, I want you to get to know these guys. These guys, God has blessed Gold City over the past 35 years with a lot of great men that have come through this ministry, men that love the Lord, that most of which have gone on into other ministries. And these guys right here are some of the greatest men that I've ever traveled with. I love each and every one of them. And I want to introduce them to you. And I'll start with this young man over here that plays the piano. This is our little piano player. Come here. Y'all need to see this. He's plumb cute, ain't he? As soon as we get through tonight, he's headed to the North Pole to get. No, let me tell you something. This young man right here is obviously blessed by God. He is not only a great piano player. He loves the Lord, and he has been playing this music on the road full-time since he was 15 years old, and he has given his life to this ministry. His name is Brian Elliott. Y'all glad to see Brian this afternoon?
Well played, Brian.
Would y'all like to hear him play something? Would that be all right? Come on, Brian. That's what happens when a piano player drinks coffee right there. Over here singing the tenor part, Thomas has been here before, and he has an incredible testimony of how God brought him to Gold City. It was completely beyond his control, and it was all God's plan. And I want him to share his testimony with you right now about why he's here. And I want you to make him welcome before he does that. This is Mr. Thomas Nally. Y'all make Thomas welcome.
Most of you guys know that I traveled with the Lefebvre Quartet for a couple years, and I love gospel music. I love everything about it. I love the message. I love meeting the people. I love singing to crowds like this. Just pumps you up, doesn't it? I love it when people are so responsive. Back in February of this year, I was at a gun range and I shot for about 30 minutes. Nothing too high caliber, but when I went to check out, I actually had all the proper hearing protection, everything. But when I went to check out, my hearing was about 5% of what it was when I went in. I met with a doctor, and sure enough, I had severe hearing loss. And went to my boss, Mr. Mike Lefebvre, and I said, "Buddy, I just can't do the job that you've hired me to do anymore. And for that reason, I want to resign." I went to him three different times, and each time he said, "No, we're going to try everything that we can. We're going to give God a chance to work this thing out. And in the meantime, we're going to do everything humanly possible that we can do." And we did. Finally accepted my resignation about 5 months later and brought on another tenor singer. I stepped back to a back role of running a product table, but I was still part of the group. But in my heart, I wanted to sing. I kept praying, and we'd go to different places, and people would say, "God's going to heal you. God's going to heal you." I remember I was taking a shower one day, and I heard distinctly, Pastor, I heard a voice say, "I'm not finished with you." I said, "God, I'm glad you're not." I said, "But I don't have the faith that I need. I believe, but help my unbelief." About a week later, we were singing at a popular television evangelist show, and five people come up and prayed for my healing and laid hands on me. And when the fifth person left, I sit back down at the table, and I heard a small pop. For the first time today, there was a speaker that was mounted to the right side of that table, and I heard it. And I was sharing this with the pastor, but the human side of us wants, when there's a miracle in our life, we want to explain it away. So I went to the lady beside me, and I said, has that been on all day? And she said, "Yes, sir, it's been broadcast in the show. Have you not heard it?" And it's probably the most excited "no, ma'am" that I've ever said in my life. But I knew at that moment that God had restored what the devil had taken. Amen. But I was still without a job. Yeah, I wanted to sing. And there were several opportunities that presented themselves in the next couple weeks. But there was one group that I kept pushing aside. I said, "Lord, I'm not worthy enough. I'm not talented enough to sing with these guys." And I just kept pushing it aside. Well, finally, it was the only option I had. And I said, "God, if you'll give me what I need, for some reason, you're keeping this door open. So I'm going to step into it in your power, not mine." And here I am today. I love these guys with all my heart. Couldn't have been a better fit for me. And I want to be an encouragement to you guys that whatever you're facing in your life, I don't know if you need a financial breakthrough. I don't know if you have a burden on your heart for a lost loved one. I don't know if you're sick. You need a physician. But I want to tell you that God is still in the miracle working business. I'm living proof of that. You know, the Bible tells me that He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. I'm so thankful for that. I'm thankful for my healing. I'm thankful to be able to sing tenor for Gold City. I want you to listen to Chip sing a song. If He did it back then, folks, you better believe it. He's going to do it every time.
I'd love to have seen the daughter of Jairus rise up and walk with new life, or share in the joy of blind Bartimaeus as the sun shined on his brand new eyes. Well, I can just see in the back of my mind the leper healed on the road. aside, for the faith that they had was all Jesus needed, and he'll do it every time. And he can still calm the storm on the raging blue sea when he says to the winds, peace, be still. And he can still make the lame man rise up to his feet. Yes, he still has the power to heal. And he can still save a soul and make a heart pure and whole. And he can give an old sinner new life.
Well, I know he still can, and with faith and demand, and
he'll do it every time.
Now you may be bound by the chains of confusion, and you feel like you've walked your last mile, and you've tried everything this old world has to offer, yet you can't seem to find peace of mind. Well, I bring you the news of the power of Jesus. He can heal all the pain in your life, 'cause he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And he'll do it every time. And he can still calm the storm on the raging blue sea when he says to the winds, peace, be still. And he can still make the lame man rise up to his feet. Yes, he still has the power to heal. And he can still save a soul and make a heart pure and whole. And he can give an old sinner new life.
Well, I know he still can, and with faith and demand,
he'll do it every time.
And he can still save a soul and make a heart pure and whole. And he can give an old sinner new life.
Well, I
he'll do it every time, every time.
Well, I'm a rich in faith and the hope and love. I got more than my share. Hallelujah to my magic dust over in glory, where I'm a rightful heir. I'm a rich in faith and a hope and love. I got more than my share.
Well,
hallelujah to my magic dust over in glory, where I'm a rightful heir.
My father owns a cattle on a thousand hills. I believe I own at least one. I stand in amazement to see his face, knowing that I'm his son.
Well, I'm a rich in faith and a hope and love. I got more than my share.
Well,
hallelujah to my man in dust over in glory, where I'm a rightful heir.
I've a guardian angel watching me. He'll go everywhere. But when I need my Father in heaven up above, I pray just a simple prayer. He has redeemed and forgiven me from all of my sins.
Oh, he took me in,
and he's building me a mansion beyond compare. Hallelujah, I'm a millionaire.
Yes, well, I'm rich in faith and a hope and love. I got more than my share. Over in glory, where I'm a rightful heir.
Well,
I'm rich in faith and a hope and love. I got more than my share.
Well,
I'm moving to my man in dust. Over in glory, where I'm a rightful heir. Well, I'll be moving to my man in dust. Over in glory, where I'm a rightful heir.
Oh, yes, I am.
And forgiven me from all of my sins.
Oh,
he reached way down and took me in. And he's building me a mansion beyond compare. Hallelujah, I'm a millionaire.
Oh, yes.
Play it for us if we do it. Well, and I gotta tell you guys, y'all blessed me. Y'all blessed my socks off. I was telling Sean, it's been a long time since I heard such talent and such anointing.
Yeah.
And you guys here are blessed to have them.
Amen.
Yes. And anytime y'all want to come out with us and play for us, you're welcome to. Over here singing the lead, this young man, he is 28 years old. He's 27 years old, excuse me. He didn't start singing until he was 15 years old. And at that age, he felt the urging to start singing. And God has blessed him with an awesome voice. He is a country boy through and through. You won't meet a finer young man than Mr. Chip Pull. And y'all make Chip welcome. About just over a year ago, those of you who follow Gold City will know my dad, Tim Riley. Sang bass with Gold City since the group's formation in 1980. Sang this music for over 52 years. And just over a year ago, August was a year ago, Dad suffered a stroke and was forced to come off the road. It affected his right side. He lost the use of his right side completely. His speech was severely slurred. And it was a tough thing. You know, obviously it was tough on him, but you know, it was tough for me to see my dad, my hero, in that kind of shape. But you know what? God is so good. Within just a few weeks, we were going out on the road and singing. I'll never forget it as long as I live. He was in a rehab facility, and we left out, and he still couldn't use his right side. And when we came in off the road one weekend, I went to see him, and then when I walked in the room, he said, "Hey, son," and God began to restore him. And he has regained everything that he lost in that stroke. We serve an awesome God. And after he went through that, he just turned 70 years old, and he decided that he was going to retire. And long before he made that decision, he knew that at some point he would retire. And long before that time came, he had handpicked a young man to step up and sing the bass part for Gold City. And this young man back here is one of the finest young bass singers that you'll hear anywhere. His name is Chris West. Are y'all glad to see Chris? Is it all right if we do something fun? Now, I love those old hymns that I grew up singing in church. I love new songs, don't get me wrong, But as a kid growing up, we used to sing those great old hymns of the church. And those songs are special to me. And so we decided to do a CD of our favorite old hymns. And as we were putting the songs together for that CD, I remembered a song that I grew up singing in church, but I'd heard it done by a black gospel quartet called the Dixie Hummingbirds. And they did this song different than I'd ever heard it. They did it different than we did it in my little Baptist church. In fact, had we done it the way the Dixie Hummingbirds did it, we'd have done it the way we're about to do it at my church when I was a kid. We'd have had deacons rushing the stage. It'd have been bad. It'd have been a scene. But I think that we can get away with it here tonight. So we're going to do this old song, Farther Along.
Cheer up.
love that song. You know, there's a lot of things that we don't understand. You know, the devil is, the Bible says that he is like a lion seeking whom he may devour. He wants to steal your joy. He wants to take everything from you. And he's not waiting for you just to casually pass by. The Bible says he is seeking whom he may devour. He's looking for you. He's waiting for an end. And sometimes we don't understand why God allows certain things to happen. Sometimes bad things happen to good people. We don't understand why a faithful servant of God goes through some of the things that we go through. Why cancer? And the list just goes on and on. I was talking with Sean earlier, and he was talking about he lost his brother a few years back of cancer. We don't understand it. Almost 11 years ago, my brother Doug Riley, he played the drums for Gold City for 17 years. Now, we came in on a Monday morning, and late that Monday night, I got a knock at the door. And my pastor and my best friend were there to tell me that my brother had been killed in a car accident. He's 35 years old, married, had two little boys. And I remember in those moments crying out and asking God why. And I don't understand why God would allow him to be taken. I don't believe God made him get in a car accident. But he could have stopped it. And I don't understand it. Now, my brother was saved. I know he is in heaven. I know I'll see him again. We sang a song earlier, I'm saved, I'm sure, I'm ready. He wrote that song. He wrote the song that Chip sang for you. He'll do it every time. At my brother's funeral, one of the preachers that spoke used an illustration that made so much sense to me. He said, he used an illustration about cross stitch. And I'm sure that most of you know what that is. If you look at the underside of cross stitch, it makes absolutely no sense. You don't understand what you're looking at. You don't understand what it all means. It looks like a mess. He said, but when you see it from the other side, then you see the beauty in the plan. We don't understand what we go through here, but one day we'll see the other side. I'm so thankful that we serve a God that is faithful. We serve a God that keeps his promises. And no matter what valley you may be walking through right now, if you'll put your trust in Jesus Christ, he'll walk with you every step of the way.
When I think I'm going under, part the waters, Lord. And when I feel the waves around me, calm the sea. cry for help. Please hear me, Lord, and hold out your hand. Touch my life and still the raging storm in me.
I need thee every hour, most gracious Lord. No tender voice like thine can peace afford. I need thee, oh, I need thee. In joy or pain, come quickly and abide, or life is vain.
I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. I come to thee.
Oh, I need thee, oh, I need thee. Every hour I need thee. Oh, bless me now, my Savior.
With Lamb not
giving up.
No, I'm not
turning round.
For by the
grace of God, I'll win a shining crown someday.
Well, I'm gonna keep
a holding on.
Yes, to that
nail-scarred head.
Oh, no, I'm not
giving up.
And no,
I'll keep going.
Been a walking through the valley, through this veil of tears. At times I've even questioned, even if my Lord was near. You see, many times that old tempter, he says, why not turn around? 'Cause you can't get any farther, because you're just losing ground. Oh, but I'm not
giving up.
No, I'm not
turning around.
For by the
grace of God, I'll win a shining crown someday.
Well, I'm gonna keep on
holding on.
Yes, to that
nail-scarred head.
Oh, no, I'm not
giving up. And no, I'll keep going on.
Well, would you mind to tell me there's been something master in me. Why is it that that old devil, he just won't let God's children be? The seed he has burst, and it has determined to get right in the way and turn us from the way of life and lead our souls astray. Oh, but I'm not giving up. No, I'm not. And I'm not
turning around.
For by the grace of God, I'll win a shining crown someday. Well, I'm gonna keep
holding on.
Yes, I will. To that nail-scarred
head.
Oh, no, I'm not
giving up.
I know I'll keep going on. Well, I'm not
giving up.
Again and
no, I'm not
turning round.
I'm turning round.
For by the grace of God, I'll win a shining crown someday. Well, I'm gonna keep
a holding on.
A holding on.
Yes, to that nail-scarred
head. That nail-scarred head.
With a shining crown someday.
I'll keep holding on, holding on
to that nail-scarred
head.
Oh, I'm not
giving up.
I know I'll keep going on.
Oh, how many of you know you don't have to give up no matter what the devil throws at you? Come on, y'all, help us stop this right here.
No, I'm not
turning around.
For by the grace of my God, I'm gonna win a shining crown someday.
I'll keep holding on, holding on
to that
nail-scarred head.
Just wanted to make a real quick announcement for those that are listening in on live stream. We're glad to have you today. We have a full live stream audience today. But before, I just wanted to let them know we're going to take a short intermission. Don't go away. Gold City's going to be right back. We're just going to take a short intermission. God bless you.
Amen.